How you doing? Back at it, it's Motivational Monday. I know you're probably getting tired of my content. My name is Kerry Hartley and I hold millennials accountable to changing the world. So we just had the rough patch on Instagram, we just got the rough draft, so now I'm gonna give you the real deal on Facebook. So here we go. Without any further ado, we're gonna get started with Motivational Monday. So what we're gonna start off this week, and we're gonna have a simple thing that my pastor does all the time. It's three simple things to see, three simple things to do, and three, since I'm not the pastor, it's three carry points. So after that, I hope that you'll be motivated to crush this Monday and to do something you've never ever done before and take that jump you need to launch that goal, to launch that business, to launch that brand, and get that success that you already have in inheritance. So the first thing that I want to talk about, first thing, just an overview of the goals is, this right now is talking about how to block schedule, create that schedule, like lock in your productivity time. It should be lunchtime for a lot of people, so that's why I plan for around 12. Now, your productivity is important, right? I could be stealing your time right now. So what's the one thing you can do each and every day that you can do to knock that bigger goal down, so what, so whatever the time that your frame is for? So for me, right now I'm in a season where I've been challenging myself for 100 days. This is the 100-day goal journal, and this is what I am in faith that in 100 days I will get things done. Now, I won't share too many numbers or whatever, but this morning I wrote down, basically you start off with grateful, what you're grateful for, and however many days left, you will accomplish. So you see your goal every single day. To achieve this, it says you should have three micro goals. I do the one thing, which I'm gonna explain in 1 second here, and then you have an action plan for the day. You end off the day with more gratitude, wonderful things that happened to you today. Right? Then three things you struggled with. So seeing some of the things that went tough that day. We won't say failures or losses, but we'll just say tough things that happened that day so you can really physically see exactly what you were challenged with. And then create some solutions, get your mind working. After that, you rate yourself 1 through 5 on discipline. Then you rate yourself 1 through 5 on an overall day. From there, are you closer to your goal? You're holding yourself accountable, yes or no? And then you have a final thought. So this is my little schedule, right? I have a block schedule. Right now, I'm in my work schedule. Right now, I'm pushing out content, so I'll probably create a content section, right? But what I don't do is have my new things each and every day. Your job may make you do that, but in your daily life, in your Google Calendar, whatever you do to like run the I Am Inc., you'll have that on the block schedule if you want to implement these strategies. So three simple things to do. The first thing is I would highly suggest you to look into some type of an overview on the book. I love to read books. If you like ebooks, go find it. Grind it, you can find this book, right? This is real simple, it's really easy to market it, but it's by Gary Keller and Jay Papasan, right? Gary Keller is the founder of KW Realty. You see KW everywhere in Atlanta. But anyway, the reason why is because it teaches you how to do the one thing that's gonna get you to your goal. And for me, it's 100 days. For you, it may be a year. For you, it may be next week. But you do one thing each and every day. I hate patience. It's not my thing. It's not my forte. I think so. But what I had to do is reprogram my mind to say, if I do one thing a day, the domino effect will knock everything down, or the snowball effect. So the second thing you need to do, which I suggest, is to create some type of journaling structure. Why? Because holding yourself accountable is the most important part. Your goals are your goals. If you go to work, you got objectives, KPIs, all this other stuff that you need to do. If you're in school, you got lesson plans, you got tests, you got a course. All of that stuff is stealing your time. So what I also say is, remember, you have productivity hackers. Like, they're trying to steal your time and they're trying to take you away from what you need to do. Like big value items on your block schedule. Hey, I'm gonna knock this out today. So this book here helped me. You don't have to use it. You can go into Barnes & Noble. I'm not telling you to steal. Look through this book. I think, let me find the artist. John Lee Dumas. You can go into Barnes & Noble, Books A Million, wherever. Look through it and create your own. All it really is starting with gratitude. From there, you're telling yourself the one thing you're gonna do. Oh, sorry, right before that, you remind yourself of your goal. Repeat like your one thing you're gonna do for that day, and then just, I usually sometimes have one thing. Yesterday it was church. All I do is dedicate Sundays to my spiritual growth. It can be something else for you. Some days I may have three things, like today. I have a call right after this. I'm gonna create a YouTube video. But the one thing that I'm doing today is creating a YouTube video on business credit such that by doing so, everything else will be easier or unnecessary. At the nighttime, gratitude, finish it off with rating myself and giving myself accountability, and then a final thought. And the third simple thing you need to see is the fact that accountability is important. If you're not writing down your goals, if you don't know your one thing, reminding yourself every day what your first, like what your goal is in 100 days or 90 days, 30 days, whatever have it, then you will forget. I showed on Instagram, I have my vision board up there. There's a ton of words, right? But some people may have visions that are just visual for them. You may have a video that you go see every day. Your background on your phone has all of your goals. Just, you could be really creative, create a collage. But I could go there every day, but I have to do something each and every day to bring that to the physical world. Manifest my destiny right now. So three simple things to do, and I'll kind of wrap it up because I know you guys are on lunch. You probably want to do something great, get some food, relax. So three simple things to do is, number one, I want you to remember that you are amazing. Why is this important? Because you have to give yourself some self-love. You have to, my dog wants some self-love right now, but you have to remind yourself that you are amazing and you can do this. You have to motivate yourself, affirmation, do something today, right now on lunch, like, hey, I am present, I am great, I am thankful. Whatever you wanna do to hype yourself up and give yourself the level of, like, I would say, energy to do what you have to do today, do it. This Monday is yours. The first of the month slaps people in the face every week. This does not have to be that week. Second thing I want you to do is to go ahead and invest in yourself. I've invested in my goals with this book. I've invested with my mindset with this book. Whatever you need to do. Maybe investing in yourself is just calling your mentor, calling somebody in your family that helps you, hold you accountable and say, hey, I really want to take it serious this week. And the third simple thing to do is the block schedule. Look it up. I'll probably even do a YouTube video on it. What it is, it just stops your day from getting those productivity hackers. Why? Because those productivity hackers are things that steal your time. Right now, my dog is bouncing the ball in front of my foot. That obviously means, hey, Carrie, I wanna go to the dog park. Hey, Carrie, I wanna go to the dog park. I know this, but I have to be productive. This time right now is work block. I have a family and dog park. I'm being blocked on my schedule. That will happen. But you don't wanna do the little things that steal your time, even at work. So find that schedule that works for you and then follow it. For me, I also want to suggest, these are just my points, carry points now, is the idea of how you wake up or how you start your day. It's important. One of my good close friends, colleague Cedric, told me, hey, every morning I wake up at a certain time, I do a certain thing every single day. I've been implementing that. Today was a rough day. Started off in Atlanta, super foggy. I'm like literally waking up and it does not feel like the sun is gonna come out. It's just gonna rain all day. That could really mess with people's minds, right? But guess what? I knew at this time I should be doing this, should be doing this, should be doing that. It flows. It's not one thing like, hey, I gotta write out this much content for the week. I gotta do this such and such for videos. I gotta write. No, I know this is the work block. So I do work during this time. I know there's a certain block where I have the next phase or the next season of the day. So creating that is important for you. Second path, now I'm not the pastor, but this is my pastor's template for how he does the sermons. Second carry part is I want you to know that your goals are only as good as your accountability. Like really, I know I keep stressing it, but I hold myself accountable. Twice this week, last week, I wasn't journaling. So I was doing things, but there's no way I can hold myself accountable. All I could put is NA, not available, right? That hurts me every time I put it in. Why? Because these are my goals. Why wouldn't I wanna put time into that? And why wouldn't I wanna invest in that and know where I am? And the third point is, I know, you know, we're kind of getting to the end of this, but I really, really, really wanted to also let you know that this year is almost over, right? It's almost over. We have three times, gotta bring it back to it, three times, if you're doing the 100-day goal journal, that you can create a goal and finish it and accomplish it every year and still have 65 days left over. And it also says in the one thing that it takes 66 days on average, however, from their studies, to build a habit. So you can build three habits, you can accomplish three goals, and you can literally still have time left over to do something else. That's so much time in a year. I mean, like big goals. Like my goal in this book is huge. It's bigger than anything I've ever done. It's bigger than anything in my family has ever done. But that's just one goal. We could do this three times a year and keep improving and letting that domino knock down the next domino. So what are we gonna do with the rest of this year, right? How much time do we have left? Put yourself on the schedule, knock it down, find the one thing you could do every single day, and then hold yourself accountable. And get those three goals that people were like fighting all year for one goal. I have like, I don't know, over 100 things on this board. Some things have really come to fruition for me. Some things I still need to work on. In the beginning of the year, I wasn't following this, but now, for the past whatever 40 days, I've been super productive because now I have accountability. I could throw all of that up on January 1, and what happens is you don't know where your goals are. I can see this every day, which is still helpful, but I'm not writing on it. I'm not grading myself on it. I'm not holding myself accountable. So you got this. Now I said, I'm Carrie Hartley. I hold millennials accountable to changing the world because I'm a millennial that wants to change the world for the positive. And I'm holding you accountable today, no matter if you're a millennial or not, to hold yourself accountable to your own goals. I know it sounds simple, you might be already doing it, but I'm just saying, hey, you're a rock star. And if you aren't, I'm saying, hey, it's okay. I was not doing the same thing. But this Motivational Monday is about checking in on your goals. Because the end of the year is almost here. And I know I got a lot of time on the clock. I'm a Knicks fan. That can be real bad for a lot of people if you're a basketball fan, right? But guess what? The same mindset for my life is how I would hope my Knicks would put on that court. Is if there's time on the clock, I'm balling. I'm out here, I'm grinding, I'm eating. Because there's no time left on the clock, that means the game is over. But as my pastor said, it's not over until I win. That's not an ego thing, it's not a chest bumping thing. It's a faith thing. It's not over till I win. Put that time back on that clock. I'm going out there and I'm grinding. I'm getting it done. My schedule is a lot, it's allocated for me to win. My goals are allocated for it to win. My accountability and myself is allocated for it to win. So you go win, and I cannot wait to see you at the top because there's plenty of room up here. You know, what other people say is there's no room. You can't be here. Go down there. Nah. As Nipsey Hussle said, when you get there, drop a rope. So let's drop a rope for each other and let's get to the top of our goals. So I'm saluting out on that. I hope we have a great motivational week, not just the Monday. And I look forward to checking in with you next week. And be on the lookout for my YouTube video. Like I said, it's going to be on business credit. I probably won't drop it today. Got to find the system. But I'm killing it with content right now. And I'm holding myself accountable. But thank y'all for checking in. I hope y'all have a great rest of your day and a great rest of your lunch.